നമസ്കാരം. ഒരു നിയമസഭാ തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പ് അടുത്തിട്ട് നിൽക്കുകയാണ്. വളരെ പ്രതീക്ഷയോടെയാണ് ബി ജെ പി ഇത്തവണ തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പിനെ നേരിടാനൊരുങ്ങുന്നത്. ഇന്ന് നമ്മളോടൊപ്പമുള്ള അതിഥി ബി ജെ പിയുടെ ദേശീയ വക്താവും ബി ജെ പിയുടെ കേരളത്തിന്റെ പ്രചരണ ചുമതലയുള്ള ഗോപാൽകൃഷ്ണ അഗർവാളാണ്. ബി ജെ പിയുടെ കേരളം മുഴുവൻ യാത്ര ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ട് ബി ജെ പിയുടെ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങളെ വിലയിരുത്തിയ അദ്ദേഹത്തോട് ബി ജെ പിയുടെ പ്രവർത്തനത്തെപ്പറ്റി, ബി ജെ പിയുടെ പ്രതീക്ഷകളെപ്പറ്റി, ബി ജെ പി എന്താണ് ലക്ഷ്യം വെക്കുന്നതെന്നതിനെപ്പറ്റി നമുക്ക് ചോദിച്ചറിയാം. ഗുഡ് മോർണിംഗ് ജി.
നമസ്തേ.
I think that you have traveled extensively in Kerala for the last 2 weeks. How you assess BJP is a major political party in Kerala, or BJP will win in Kerala elections?
I have been to Kerala in this election. This is my 5th time that I have come to Kerala and moved to various places, and I am here for more than 1.5 months to 2 months. I visited Kerala different places with Nadda ji, Amit Shah ji. Even I attended program of Prime Minister Modi ji also, and myself also. I had around addressed 13 public meeting, mahasammelan, conventions, party meetings, then road shows, all these things, and many constituencies also. I find that people in Kerala are ready for a change. They want a change, because LDF and UDF have alternatively been in power in Kerala for 7 decades, 70 years, and all time they have promised many things, but ultimately 70 years is a long time where people expect them to deliver something concrete on some of the issues which they have not delivered. Some things are good, but still there are many things which in the future will affect the growth of Kerala, the economic development of Kerala, the ease of living, ease of doing business, and certain issues even in relation to tradition, culture, religion, the politics of appeasement, corruptions. So only in last 5 years I find that many issues have accumulated and are concerning the minds of individual people in Kerala, citizens of Kerala, which have not been addressed by LDF in last 5 years. I came to Kerala in the last election also. I participated in Padyatra that time also, and this time also that Yatra, Kerala Vijay Yatra. I find a big difference, and those concerns have not been addressed by LDF, and even people do not have much hope for UDF, because they have tested and tried UDF. Its leadership is completely in disarray, and they are ideologically a confused party. If you see their stand on Sabarimala, if you see their stand on communalism, secularism, then their alignment with Indian Union Muslim League, all these issues clearly point out that people have no faith or hope from UDF, and those who are not in favor of LDF surely want a shift and change for Bharatiya Janata Party, NDA combined.
Kerala has entirely a different political situation. Are you think that BJP is an alternative in Kerala?
Surely. And one thing I found very important, and this time we from the central leadership, particularly from Amit Shah ji, Nadda ji, BL Santosh ji, we have extensively tried to fight this perception. We found one thing was hindering our growth in Kerala was that our workers are very much committed here, because the Parivar has been working on the ground for many years and effectively working BJP and RSS and other organizations, etc., BMS, Kisan Sangh, Vidyarthi Parishad. They had extensively worked into the ground level for the social welfare of the people, even education and other things also. But that they were not able to convert that support and love for the party for vote to the Bharatiya Janata Party. And that was the problem that we identified, was even they were also not perceiving that BJP is fighting elections in Kerala to come to power, capture power to rule Kerala, and therefore that perception in itself that BJP is just here for increasing its vote shares was in itself hurting our growth in Kerala. And this time we have tried to completely fight this, remove this misconception and concern, and we have been telling everybody, and this is now being reflected in the campaign also and the people's approach also here, workers, leaders, state leaders, and even people's approach, that this time BJP is going to fight election for coming to power. NDA combined is definitely in a very good position to form a ruling coalition in this Kerala, and Bharatiya Janata Party fights under our current leadership every election, from panchayat to state election to the national leader elections, to come to power and bring our ideology and implementational policies at the ground level. This perceptional change itself is also going to the people, and therefore whatever anti-incumbency vote is there, instead of going to UDF from the LDF, this time majority will now vote for Bharatiya Janata Party NDA combined. And another point is also very important here is in our strategy that UDF and LDF for all elections has never in their previous elections, CPM and Congress together have not crossed the 50% point vote in their favor. It is always a coalition government in Kerala. So why NDA cannot form a coalition government, that is also I am very sure that this also is a clear message that people are getting here.
Is the political situation favorable to that coalition to BJP?
Surely. We have met even the three topmost cardinals from India, met Prime Minister personally in Delhi, then almost 17-18 archbishops across the country went to meet to the Prime Minister personally, and Prime Minister has also come here several times, and the issues like love jihad, even grabbing of land, the issue of PFI, you know, the person, Christian young one teacher, hands was chopped off. So they are also facing similar kind of violence from the left initiated people, supporters, and even from the Indian Union Muslim League dominated areas, that kind of violence and everything is being faced by them also, and they are more worried about them than even communities like some caste communities like Nair and Ejwa, everything. They also have come out with supporting BJP because of issues like Sabarimala and all these things, and safety of women is also a big concern. I went to Shornur. The MLA there from the LDF has been allegations of molestation by the women, and the LDF government announced that we will have an in-house inquiry about them, and in their in-house inquiry they have found and come out with the report that it's a minor molestation. What do you mean by minor and major molestation? And women are very strong in Kerala. They are very well educated, they are working, and the sex ratio percentage, gender ratio here is higher for women. It is a very healthy sign. So they are also concerned about women's safety and other issues. And the major concern that I found among the women voters is that their dependence on remittances, the whole growth of the Kerala is solely dependent on remittances, which is going to dry. So BJP has a clear cut vision for Kerala. We are unleashing that vision even in the form of Atmanirbhar Kerala, Why BJP, several programs with professional industrialists, business communities, caste community leadership, all are being held by the different leaders, and that is going to make a big change.
So the BJP was formed in 1980. The party is yet to make any impact on Kerala. Was it the failure of the leadership of Kerala?
I will not call it a failure of leadership. Kerala society is a complex society. Even when I met Archbishop in Thrissur, he said that we have a 70 different sects within the Christianity. And you know, Kerala is a very ancient society. It's considered to, Thrissur is considered the knowledge capital of Kerala, and I find that the cities certain have, it can has the potential of not only being a cultural capital for Kerala but India. That is the potential. We have great leaders like Shankaracharya, etc., who have created lot of philosophy, literature, and the culture, tradition, religion, temple, all these are well entrenched into the Kerala society. It is very complex society. So it takes some time, even some leadership also to recognize and put in force, because LDF itself was indulging in, you see, across globe and even in India, communist ideology believes in violence and fear, creating fear. They had been creating that fear and violence in the minds of our supporters and workers, and more than 130 our karyakartas and young people have lost their life because of the violence by LDF. You must be knowing about Rajesh, a 30-year young boy was brutally killed in front of her mother, pulled out of her house in front of her mother, and brutally thrashed and killed. So I have seen those pictures. It is very much disturbing, and that kind of fear and violence at times was helping them capture violence. Then a politics of appeasement also of UDF, that aligning with Indian Union Muslim League, all these things were making it difficult. But you see Bharatiya Janata Party's extensive reach this time in the south has been very focused, and after Karnataka, and now Puducherry will be also in our kitty, we are very sure, and Tamil Nadu, we have an NDA government. We are very positive and hopeful that Kerala will come to our kitty this time, and BJP wants its outreach into south. It's very important, and we believe that south is a major source of preservation of our culture, tradition, religion, etc., which Bharatiya Janata Party alone respects and cares for, whether it is tradition, temple, control, etc., or politics of non-appeasement, and true secularism is only that BJP leadership can give, in addition to what we do for economic development, growth, ease of doing business, building infrastructure. I can completely give you a big roadmap that our party has come out for a strong Kerala, economically empowered Kerala, employment generation, agro-based industries, good infrastructure of railways, waterways, airways, and bridges, etc. So together all these things is attracting people, and people have a strong faith in the leadership and commitment of Shri Narendra Modi ji, that whatever under his leadership Bharatiya Janata Party promises in its manifesto or in its lectures of the leaders, we implement it verbatim, even including putting a flagging of each and every issue. So people have strong faith in Narendra Modi ji's leadership and commitment, and that is also helping us.